We are going to start module 1 of chapter 7. In this module, we shall discuss brackets. Brackets is a very powerful tool, particularly in classical mechanics. It can be used in a very sophisticated way to represent classical mechanics into a mathematical form. Brackets are basically a mapping which maps two functions into a new function. In this module, we shall discuss the detail about it. In this module, we shall discuss brackets. First of all, we shall define Poisson bracket. Then, we'll prove the Poisson theorem. We shall put Hamilton's equations in terms of Poisson brackets. Then we will show that Poisson bracket is invariant. Then we will define Lagrange bracket. Let us define Poisson bracket. Poisson bracket is an operation which takes two functions of phase space and time and produces a new function. Let us consider two functions, capital F 1, which is a function of generalized coordinate small q I, generalized momenta small p I and t, and capital F 2, which is a function of small q I, small p I and t. Then the Poisson bracket is defined as Poisson bracket of capital F 1 and capital F 2 is equal to summation over I equal to 1 to n first order partial derivative of capital F 1 with respect to small q I into first order partial derivative of capital F 2 with respect to small p I minus first order partial derivative of capital F 1 with respect to small p I into first order partial derivative of capital F 2 with respect to small q I. For single degree of freedom, please note that for single degree of freedom I becomes only 1, then Poisson bracket takes the following form: Poisson bracket of capital F 1 F 2 equal to first order partial derivative of capital F 1 with respect to small q into first order partial derivative of capital F 2 with respect to small p minus first order partial derivative of capital F 1 with respect to small p into first order partial derivative of capital F 2 with respect to small q. Basically, in Poisson bracket, each term contains one derivative of capital F 1 and one derivative of capital F 2. One derivative is considered with respect to a coordinate small q and the other is with respect to the conjugate momentum small p. A change of sign occurs in the terms depending on which function is differentiated with respect to the coordinate and which with respect to the momentum. Remark: some authors use square brackets to represent the Poisson bracket, that is, instead of second bracket of capital F 1, capital F 2, they prefer to use third bracket of capital F 1, capital F 2. Problem 1. Obtain the Poisson bracket for the functions small p minus q and sin q. Let capital F 1 function of small q small p equal to small p minus small q, capital F 2 function of small q small p equal to sin small q. Then the Poisson bracket is given by second bracket capital F 1 capital F 2 equal to first order partial derivative of capital F 1 with respect to small q into first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small p minus first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small p into first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small q. After calculating these partial derivatives and substituting these, we get Poisson bracket of F1 F2, that is within second bracket F1 F2 equal to minus 1 into 0 minus 1 into cos q, which on simplification gives Poisson bracket of capital F1 and capital F2 is equal to minus cos q. Next problem. Find the Poisson bracket for the functions small p plus small q and cos small p. Let capital F1 function of small q small p equal to small p plus small q, capital F2 function of small q small p equal to cos small p, then the Poisson bracket is Poisson bracket of capital F1 capital F2 equal to within second bracket capital F1 capital F2 is equal to first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small q into first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small p minus first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small p into first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small q. After calculating the partial derivative and putting in this equation, we get Poisson bracket of capital F1 capital F2 equal to 1 into minus sin p minus 1 into 0. Since first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to q gives 1, first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small p gives minus sin p, first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small p gives 1, whereas first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small q gives 0. On simplification, we get Poisson bracket of capital F1 F2 equal to minus sin p. That is, within second bracket capital F1 F2 equal to minus sin p. Poisson brackets of the canonical variables have the following form. Poisson bracket of small q y small q j equal to 0, that is within second bracket small q y small q j equal to 0. Poisson bracket of small p I small p j equal to 0, that is within second bracket small p I small p j equal to 0. Poisson bracket of small q y small p j equal to conical delta I j, where conical delta I j equal to 1 for I equal to j. If I not equals to j, then conical delta I j equal to 0. Please note that small q y and small q j are the generalized coordinates, whereas small p I and small p j are the generalized momenta. Now, let us calculate the Poisson bracket of generalized coordinates small q y small q j. Poisson bracket of small q y small q j is equal to summation over k first order partial derivative of small q y with respect to small q k into first order partial derivative of small q j with respect to small p k minus first order partial derivative of small q y with respect to small p k into first order partial derivative of small q j with respect to small q k. This becomes 0 since small q j is independent of small p k. So, first order partial derivative of small q j with respect to small p k equal to 0. And similarly, first order partial derivative of small q y with respect to small p k equal to 0. Now, let us calculate the Poisson bracket of the generalized momenta p I p j. Poisson bracket of p I p j equal to summation over k first order partial derivative of small p I with respect to small q k into first order partial derivative of small p j with respect to small p k minus first order partial derivative of small p I with respect to small p k into first order partial derivative of small p j with respect to small q k equal to 0 using the same result, that is first order partial derivative of p I with respect to q k equal to 0 since p I is independent of q k and first order partial derivative of p j with respect to q k is also 0. Now, let us calculate the Poisson bracket of small q y small p j. That is, we are calculating the Poisson bracket of a combination of generalized coordinate and momenta. Poisson bracket of small q y small p j equal to summation over k first order partial derivative of small q y with respect to small q k into first order partial derivative of small p j with respect to small p k minus first order partial derivative of small q y with respect to small p k into first order partial derivative of small p j with respect to small q k. Now, first order partial derivative of q y with respect to q k gives Kronecker delta I k, whereas first order partial derivative of p j with respect to p k gives Kronecker delta j k. On the other hand, first order partial derivative of q y with respect to p k vanishes. First order partial derivative of p j with respect to q k vanishes. So, we have Poisson bracket of small q y small p j equal to summation over k Kronecker delta I k into Kronecker delta j k, which gives Kronecker delta I j. We have discussed Poisson bracket and some properties of it. Now, Poisson bracket is basically a relation between a pair of dynamical variables. It gives a link between the classical mechanics and quantum mechanics. Now, we shall prove that Poisson bracket remains invariant under canonical transformation, which is a very powerful technique particularly in classical mechanics. Now, Poisson theorem. The total time rate of evaluation of any dynamical variable capital F, which is a function of small q, small p, t, is given by first order ordinary derivative of capital F with respect to time t is equal to del del t of capital F plus Poisson bracket of capital F comma capital H, where capital H is the Hamiltonian of the system. D dt of capital F is also known as total derivative. Proof. We know that d dt of capital F equal to first order partial derivative of capital F with respect to small t plus summation over I equal to 1 to n first order partial derivative of capital F with respect to small q y into small q y dot plus first order partial derivative of capital F with respect to small p I into small p I dot. Here, we have used the chain rule of differentiation. Now, If we use the Hamilton's equations of motion in this right hand side portion, then we get d dt of capital F equal to del del t of capital F plus summation I equal to 1 to n first order partial derivative of capital F with respect to small q y into first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small p I minus first order partial derivative of capital F with respect to small p I into first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small q y. The second part gives the Poisson bracket of capital F with H. Thus, we finally have d dt of capital F equal to first order partial derivative of capital F plus Poisson bracket of capital F comma capital H. Now, Hamilton's equations of motion in terms of Poisson brackets. We know that Hamilton's equations of motion are given by small q dot equal to first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small p, whereas small p dot equal to first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small q with a negative sign. Now, the Poisson bracket of small q and capital H gives first order partial derivative of q with respect to small q into first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small p minus first order partial derivative of small q with respect to small p into first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small q. This gives Poisson bracket of small q comma capital H equal to first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small p. Since first order partial derivative of q with respect to q gives 1, whereas first order partial derivative of q with respect to small p gives 0. So, we finally have Poisson bracket of q comma H equal to del del p of capital H equals to small q dot. From Hamilton's equation we get it. Similarly, Poisson bracket of small p comma capital H equal to first order partial derivative of small p with respect to small q into first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small p minus first order partial derivative of small p with respect to small p into first order partial derivative of capital H with respect to small q. Since first order partial derivative of small p with respect to small q gives 0, whereas first order partial derivative of small p with respect to small p gives 1, so we get Poisson bracket of small p comma capital H equal to minus del del q of capital H. From Hamilton's equation we finally get Poisson bracket of small p comma capital H equal to small p dot. Theorem: Poisson bracket is invariant under canonical transformation. Let us prove this. Let us consider the canonical transformation small q small p t transforms to capital Q capital P t given by capital Q I equal to capital Q I function of small q 1 small q 2 up to small q n, small p 1 small p 2 up to small p n and t. Capital P I equal to capital P I function of small q 1 small q 2 up to small q n, small p 1 small p2 up to small pn and t. Let the dynamical variables capital F1, which is a function of generalized coordinate q, generalized momenta small p time t, and capital F2, which is a function of generalized coordinate small q, generalized momenta small p and time t, transform to capital F1 bar function of small q, small p, t, and capital F2 bar function of small q, small p, t, which is given by capital F1 function of small q, small p, t equal to capital F1, which is a function of small q. Small q is again a function of capital Q, capital P, T. Small p function of capital Q, capital P, T and T. This can be written as capital F1 bar function of capital Q, capital P, T. In a similar fashion, we can write capital F2 function of small q, small p, T as capital F2 bar, which is a function of capital U, capital P, T. We have to show that Poisson bracket of capital F1, capital F2 is equal to Poisson bracket of capital F1 bar, capital F2 bar. Now, let us calculate the first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small q y. Therefore, del del q y of capital F1 equal to summation over j equal to 1 to small n first order partial derivative of capital F1 bar with respect to capital q j into first order partial derivative of capital q j with respect to small q y plus first order partial derivative of capital F1 bar with respect to capital Pj into first order partial derivative of capital Pj with respect to small qy. Here we have used the chain rule. This gives del del small qy of capital F1 equal to summation over j equal to 1 to n del del capital Qj of capital F1 bar into del del capital Pj of small pi minus del del capital Pj of capital F1 bar into del del capital Qj of small pi. We have used the canonical transformations given in the next line. Now, we can calculate in a similar fashion the first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small pi, which is summation j equal to 1 to n first order partial derivative of capital F1 bar with respect to capital Qj into first order partial derivative of capital Qj with respect to small pi plus first order partial derivative of capital F1 bar with respect to capital Pj into first order partial derivative of capital Pj with respect to small pi. If we use the canonical transformations given in the last line, then we get first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small pi equal to summation over j equal to 1 to n minus del del capital Qj of capital F1 bar del del capital Pj of small qi plus del del capital Pj of capital F1 bar del del capital Qj of small qi. These are the partial derivatives. Poisson bracket of capital F1 capital F2 is given by summation I equal to 1 to small n first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small qy into first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small pi minus first order partial derivative of capital F1 with respect to small pi into first order partial derivative of capital F2 with respect to small q1. Now, we want to change capital F1 in terms of capital F1 bar, while F2 remain the same. Replacing F1 in terms of capital F1 bar, we get the result which has been written in the second line. If we split the result, then we can get the result which has been written in the next line. Since the terms within the third bracket takes the simpler form, like first order partial derivative of capital F2 bar with respect to capital Pj, and the terms within the third bracket in the above line takes the simpler form, like the first order partial derivative of capital F2 bar with respect to capital Qj. Substituting these, we can get the result in a simple form, like Poisson bracket of capital F1 capital F2 equal to summation over j equal to 1 to n first order partial derivative of capital F1 bar with respect to capital Qj into first order partial derivative of capital F2 bar with respect to capital Pj minus first order partial derivative of capital F1 bar with respect to capital Pj into first order partial derivative of capital F2 bar with respect to capital Qj. This gives the Poisson bracket of two transformed variables, capital F1 bar and capital F2 bar, which have been written in the right hand side of last but one line. Thus, the theorem is proved. Now, we shall define Lagrange bracket. If small q1, small q2 up to small qn, small p1, small p2 up to small pn is a system of canonical coordinates in a phase space, and if capital F1 and capital F2 be the functions of those variables, then the Lagrange bracket is defined as Lagrange bracket of capital F1 capital F2, that is within third bracket capital F1 capital F2, equal to summation over I equal to 1 to small n first order partial derivative of small qi with respect to capital F1 into first order partial derivative of small pi with respect to capital F2 minus first order partial derivative of small pi with respect to capital F1 into first order partial derivative of small qi with respect to capital F2. Please note that for Lagrange bracket, we have used the third bracket, whereas to denote Poisson bracket, we have used the second bracket. Now, we shall discuss properties of Lagrange bracket. Lagrange bracket is anti-commutative, that is, Lagrange bracket of capital F1 capital F2 equal to minus Lagrange bracket of capital F2 capital F1. Lagrange bracket does not depend on the canonical coordinates, that is, Lagrange bracket is an invariant under the canonical transformations. Now, we shall prove that Lagrange bracket is canonical invariant. Lagrange bracket of capital F1 capital F2 is defined as within third bracket capital F1 capital F2 equal to summation over I first order partial derivative of small qi with respect to capital F1 into first order partial derivative of small pi with respect to capital F2 minus first order partial derivative of small qi with respect to capital F2 into first order partial derivative of small pi with respect to capital F1. This can be combined and written in the right hand side of this equation, which is Lagrange bracket of capital F1 capital F2 equal to summation over I Jacobian of qi pi with respect to capital F1 capital F2. In previous chapter we have proved that summation over I Jacobian of qi pi with respect to capital F1 capital F2 is invariant under canonical transformation. So Lagrange bracket is invariant under canonical transformation. Bracket is a powerful tool in classical mechanics. In this module we have discussed about it. Poisson bracket and Lagrange bracket have been defined and shown that both are invariant under canonical transformation. Poisson bracket gives the geometrical structure of phase space transformation.